Hello, everyone. Merging LoRA models to a checkpoint can be a challenging task, especially for those interested in stable diffusion and AI art through LoRA training. But fear not. If you're passionate about stable diffusion and exploring the creative potential of LoRA in AI art, we have just the solution for you. In this YouTube video, we'll guide you step by step on how to effectively merge LoRA models to a checkpoint, empowering you to unleash the full artistic capabilities of LoRA in your AI creations. So, if you're ready to take your stable diffusion and AI art with LoRA to the next level, stay tuned and let's dive into the world of merging LoRA models. Today we are going to talk about how to merge the LoRA model into a checkprint. Last time, we showed you how to merge LoRA models together. Also, we showed you how to extract a LoRA model from a checkpoint. If you have not watched these videos yet, you can find the link here or in the description below. Like last time, I will use a new workspace to do it. I will create a folder called LoRA to model. Change directory to the workspace. And then I will create a bash script called loratomodel.sh. First, change directory to the sdscripts folder. This time we will use the merge LoRA Python script. Let's see how to call it. Run the merge LoRA -h option to run the bash script in the terminal. Activate the sdscripts conda environment. Give execute permission to the file. Then we can run it. Okay. This is the help. Copy and paste here. How to run it. This time we need to merge a LoRA model into a checkpoint. We use FP16 as the save precision. We can skip the precision. SD model is the path to the checkpoint. I will use chillout mix. Models are the path to the LoRA models. I will use the LoRA model I trained in the last video. Ratio. If we want to apply all effect to the checkpoint, use 1.0. Save to is the output path we want. Just save the output here. Choose any name you want. Let's check it once more time. Okay, we can try to run it. It saved to this path. Hey there. If you're enjoying the content so far, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. By hitting that subscribe button, you'll be the first to know when we release new videos. Don't forget to turn on notifications as well, so you never miss out. In a web UI, let's see how the LoRA model looks like. I use the chillout mix as the checkpoint. Let's try to generate 4 images. Okay, this is how the LoRA model looks like. Now we try to see the results without the LoRA model. Okay, this is how the results look like without the LoRA model. Now we try to see the results using our new checkpoint. Refresh the model list. Choose our own checkpoint. There is no LoRA model in the prompt. Let's generate the images. Okay. This is the results. The checkpoint really got our LoRA effect. Let's compare the two sets of images. On the left, are the images using LoRA model? On the right, are the images using the new checkpoint? Observation. We can merge the LoRA model into a checkpoint. I found that it's quite useful because I will not forget to put the LoRA tag into the prompts. More. You can try to merge more than one LoRA model into the checkpoint. You can also try to use different weights when doing it. Please let us know your results in the comment below. The Colab notebook can be found in the description below. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about stable diffusion and LoRA training, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. I will put up the other video soon. You can also find all the models and images in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description. Thank you and see you in the next video.